Hi, my name is Łukasz Towarek. I'm graphics software engineer at Intel. Today I would like to take you on a trip down the compute pipeline. The main goal of the presentation is to show how Intel GPU OpenCL software stack is built and how components interact with each other when running a simple OpenCL application. Modern, low-overhead APIs like Vulkan and Level 0 are mentioned to highlight differences in drivers' activities when operating on different API concepts like command lists. Let's start with a component overview. Intel GPU Compute Stack consists of two main parts: software, which programs the hardware according to the user requests, and hardware that does the computation. Software stack is split into user mode driver and kernel mode driver. The main component of user mode driver is compute runtime, which contains both OpenCL and Level 0 runtimes, as well as code shared between both implementations. Goal of runtime components is to map OpenCL and Level 0 API calls into hardware constructs. Compute Runtime interacts with Intel Graphics Compiler, IGC, to compile compute kernels, with Graphics Memory Management Library, GMM, to properly program memory surfaces, and finally with the Kernel Mode Driver to send commands to the hardware. Intel GPU Kernel Mode Driver, i915, is part of Direct Rendering Manager, DRM, subsystem of the Linux kernel. From the OpenCL and Level 0 point of view, the most important component of i915 is Graphics Execution Manager, GEM, which is responsible for graphics memory management and graphics device execution context. Now let's check how mentioned components interact with each other when running a simple OpenCL application. CLGet platform IDs is the first API call that interacts with the OpenCL runtime. To return CL platform handle, OpenCL runtime needs to find supported devices in the system, get device details from the KMD, i915 may query the hardware for requested capabilities or simply return values from a prepopulated structure based on a device ID. Create GEM context for each supported hardware engine. KMD in this case creates only a handle which will be assigned to the hardware context on a first use. Initialize driver internals and finally create internal platform representation. Main goal of CL build program call is to create a device binary from user provided program. In case of compilation from the source code, the first step is done by front-end compiler, which compiles OpenCLC source code into SPIRV. Such SPIRV binary is passed to the Intel Graphics compiler for further processing. As IGC is an LLVM-based compiler supporting multiple languages, SPIRV is translated into OpenCL-flavored LLVM Intermediate Representation, IR, and then into a generic LLVM IR flavor. Prepared LLVM IR is optimized in a device-agnostic way, for example with loop unrolling or inlining. Next, Virtual Instruction Set Architecture, VISA, representation is emitted from the optimized LLVM IR. Intel Graphics Assembler encodes given VISA into hardware-understandable Gen ISA binary. At the end of IGC pipeline, a structure containing device binary and program's metadata is prepared and returned to the runtime. OpenCL runtime decodes program's metadata and based on it asks i915 for GPU memory required to run a given program. OpenCL standard defines three kernel input formats: OpenCLC source code, SPIRV binaries, and native binaries. APIs like Vulkan and Level 0 do not support module creation from a source code, so there is no need for a front-end compiler. From a driver perspective, every CLNQ call is translated into two stages, command creation and command submission. Most hardware commands programmed by OpenCL runtime must be stored in a batch buffer accessible by the GPU. Multiple OpenCL commands can be stored in a single batch buffer. Command creation consists of two steps: potential batch buffer allocation when there is no space in a current one, and the update of the batch buffer with a given command. Created command is passed further to the submission phase. In case of Vulkan and Level 0, command list creation is an explicit separate phase that is under application's control. When a command list is submitted, most of required resources are already allocated and prepared for the execution. To guarantee that commands in an in-order queue are executed in the same order they are enqueued, OpenCL runtime needs to implicitly add a hardware pipeline flush command. In case of out-of-order queue, such pipeline flushes are assigned with explicit synchronization points specified by the application. Vulkan and Level 0 guarantee only that command lists and commands within a command list are started in the same order in which they are submitted, but the order of completion is not defined. Commands are submitted based on driver's heuristics. For example, if there are not enough commands in the command queue, then the driver may decide to keep batching them together. Otherwise, batched commands may be sent for the execution on the hardware. In this case, OpenCL runtime adds a GPU marker command to be able to check whether a given batch buffer is complete. Memory dependency list with all required buffer objects is created and passed to i915 alongside a request to submit given batch buffer on a given gem context. In turn, i915 binds buffer objects into GPU address space and creates a hardware context to a given gem context if such hardware context was not already assigned. Next, all buffer objects are pinned so they will not be paged out when GPU is working. Finally, the batch buffer is injected into the ring buffer and the hardware context is submitted to the GPU. Implicit command submission introduces unpredictability in the application flow. Since command lists in Vulkan and Level 0 are created beforehand by the application, it is assumed that no implicit batching is required and command queue can submit command list immediately. When CLFinish is called, OpenCL runtime flushes any remaining batch buffers to the hardware. Before returning the control flow to the caller, runtime must ensure that all submitted batch buffers are completed. In this case, the first option is to check whether previously injected GPU markers are already signaled. If yes, then it means that the batch buffer is completed and the buffer objects are unpinned. If markers are not ready, then OpenCL runtime falls back to the KMD-based logic. i915 waits for batch buffer and interrupt, and when it is triggered, unpins all used buffer objects and notifies the runtime. I hope that after this presentation you have a better understanding how the OpenCL software stack for Intel processor graphics is built, as well as when and how driver components interact with each other. Thank you.